हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स। यस्टरडे वी हैड सीन द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट ऑसिलेटरी मोशन और वाइब्रेटरी मोशन, पीरियोडिक मोशन एंड फ्रॉम दैट लीनियर सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन। सो लीनियर simple harmonic motion is nothing but a linear periodic motion in which the force or acceleration is always directed towards the mean position and its magnitude is directly proportional to the displacement of a particle measured from its mean position. So this is linear simple harmonic motion. And today our aim is to find out a differential equation of simple harmonic motion. So for that, let us consider basic equation of acceleration. What is that? Acceleration is equal to d2x by dt square, d2x by dt square. But acceleration a is equal to dv by dt, dv by dt means acceleration a is equal to dv by dt, but velocity v is equal to dx by dt, dx by dt. Hence acceleration A is equal to d dt of. If you substitute this v by dx by dt, then here you will get dx by dt. So this is equal to d2x by dt square. This is equal to d2x by dt square, which is our basic equation. Now our aim is to find out the differential equation of simple harmonic motion. So for that, how will you solve this? We have the base equation, that is force is equal to mass into acceleration. So acceleration is equal to d2x by dt square. Acceleration is equal to d2x by dt square. So we can use, so acceleration force is equal to m into a, mass into acceleration, which is equal to mass into a is given by d2x by dt square, d2x by dt square. But as we have seen earlier, this in case of linear simple harmonic motion, F is equal to minus kx. So give the equation number 1, this as 2. If you observe these two equations, the left hand side of both the equations is same. That is F and F. So we can equate these two equations. So what you will get? minus k एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस के एक्स इज इक्वल टू एम इंटू डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर. माइनस के एक्स इज इक्वल टू एम इंटू डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर. इफ यू ट्रांसफर दिस माइनस के एक्स ऑन दैट साइड देन वॉट यूल गेट एम इंटू डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू प्लस. इफ यू ट्रांसफर दिस माइनस के एक्स ऑन दैट साइड इट बिकम्स प्लस. सो के इंटू एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो और डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर दिस इज इक्वल टू प्लस के अपॉन एम इंटू एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. मीन्स इफ यू डिवाइड दिस एम ऑन बोथ साइड इफ यू डिवाइड हियर बाय एम यू विल गेट एम बाय एम मीन्स वन मीन्स डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर. इफ यू डिवाइड दिस के बाय एम सो वट यूल गेट के बाय एम इंटू एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो नाउ इफ यू सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस के बाय एम इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा स्क्वायर देन हियर वी कैन राइट इट एज डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर प्लस इंस्टेड ऑफ के बाय एम आई विल राइट ओमेगा स्क्वायर इंटू एक्स दिस इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो दिस इक्वेशन इज नथिंग बट this equation is nothing but the differential equation of simple harmonic motion. Differential equation of simple harmonic motion. Sometimes in the exam you may ask derive the differential equation of a linear simple harmonic motion of a particle. Then this question you may ask for 2 marks and by that time you should be able to write all these steps. So the same thing you can see in the PPT also. Just I will show you the PPT. Technical problem is there. So your entire screen. Yes. This is our differential equation of simple harmonic motion. So you can see F is equal to minus kx and also F is equal to m into A. So A is equal to dv by dt but v is equal to dx by dt. Just we have written there. Hence, A is equal to d2x by dt square. So, therefore, m is equal to f is equal to m into a is equal to m into d2x by dt square because A can be substituted by d2x by dt square. So, equating 1 and 2, the left hand side of both the equations is same. So, naturally, 1 मिनट। हाँ सर, हो चालू है। हाँ सो हियर इक्वेटिंग वन एंड टू व्हाट यू विल गेट, एम इंटू डी टू एक्स बाई डी टी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू माइनस के एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस के एक्स। देन डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर एम इंटू डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर प्लस के एक्स प्लस के एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड सो फाइनली रीअरेंजिंग द टर्म यू विल गेट दिस इक्वेशन डी टू एक्स बाय डी टी स्क्वायर प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर इंटू एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो वेयर के बाय एम इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा स्क्वायर दिस इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट एंड देन दिस इक्वेशन इज नथिंग बट द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ लीनियर सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन। सो द सेम थिंग वी हैव रिटन ऑन द ब्लैक बोर्ड ऑल्सो। देन एज फार एज लीनियर सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन इज कंसर्न देर आर वेरियस पैरामीटर्स सच एज डिस्प्लेसमेंट एक्सेलरेशन देन वेलोसिटी एम्पलीट्यूड फ्रीक्वेंसी एक्सेट्रा टाइम पीरियड। सो नाउ वील ऑप्टेन एन इक्वेशन फॉर एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ ए पार्टिकल विच इज परफॉर्मिंग सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन। सो फॉर दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग ब्लैक बोर्ड वील यूज पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन सो दैट कैन बी सीन ऑन यूर स्क्रीन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल we have the differential equation of simple harmonic motion which is given by d2x by dt square plus omega square into x is equal to 0. This is our differential equation. Now if you rearrange the term by transferring this omega square x is equal to 0 omega square x on the right hand side, then you will get d2x by dt square is equal to minus omega square into x. So this shape is obtained by using this differential equation. Now we know that the acceleration is equal to d2x by dt square. Acceleration is equal to d2x by dt square, that is the double differentiation of x, where x is the displacement of a particle. Then hence, we can write acceleration of a particle performing linear simple harmonic motion is given by a is equal to minus omega square into x, because here this d2x by dt square can be replaced by small a, which is our notation for acceleration. So a is equal to minus omega square into x. Then we can rearrange this acceleration d2x by dt square. Just you can see this is d2x by dt square, this is an acceleration. So this can be written as the rate of change of velocity, the rate of change of velocity, which is given by dv by dt, which is given by dv by dt. Now this dv by dt can be written as dv by dx into dx by dt, where this dx and dx, this is our adjustment in order to write this term dv by dt. Just we are divided by dx and multiplied by dx, means the original term remain unchanged. Okay, this is our adjustment. Then here dv by dx, keep it as it is, but this dx by dt, this is nothing but the rate of change of displacement, rate of change of displacement, and this is nothing but velocity v. So dx by dt is equal to v, means dx by dt can be replaced by velocity v. So acceleration, we got new equation for acceleration, and what is that? डीवी बाई डी एक्स इंटू वेलोसिटी, डीवी बाई डी एक्स इंटू वेलोसिटी वी, और वी कैन राइट इट एज वी इंटू डीवी बाई डी एक्स वन एंड द सेम थिंग, गिव द इक्वेशन नंबर एज टू. Then substitute equation number 2 in 1. Means earlier we had seen the equation number 1. And what is that? Okay. Here p into dv by dx, the differential equation d2x by dt square is equal to minus omega square. This is our equation number 1. So we can write it as v into dv by dt, v into dv by dx is equal to minus omega square into x. It just we have substitute this acceleration by v into dv by dx in our differential equation. So v into dv by dx is equal to minus omega square into x. So now we'll separate the variables. The variables of v will take it on the left hand side, and the variables of x will take it on right hand side, so that this dx should be transferred on the right hand side, so that you will get minus omega square into x into dx. So this is our equation. Now in order to solve this equation, we'll take integration on both sides. So integrating on both sides, so what you get? If you integrate this equation on both sides, the left hand side you will get integration of v dv is equal to integration of minus omega square into dx, omega square into x into dx. So here this is integration sign, this is also integration sign. So next, then the integration of integration of v dv, you can see here integration of v dv is given by v square by 2. Integration of v with respect to dv is given by v square by 2 is equal to, this omega square is constant. The omega square is constant. So we can take out it outside the integration sign. And the integration of x dx is given by x square by 2. So that you will get v square by 2 is equal to minus omega square x square by 2 plus c. So what is c? This c is the constant of integration, where c is the constant of integration. And the value of c, it depends upon the boundary conditions. So what are the boundary conditions that we'll see? Our aim is to find out this c. So when the particle is at the extreme position, velocity is equal to 0. Yesterday we have seen that when the particle reaches to extreme point, its velocity becomes 0. By that time, the displacement covered by particle is maximum. And the maximum displacement is generally denoted by capital A. So, what we can say, thus, at x is equal to plus minus A, this plus sign and minus sign, here we have considered these two signs, plus sign, positive and negative. Positive sign indicates that the particle is moving towards the positive direction of x-axis. And the negative sign is used as the particle is moving towards the negative direction of x-axis. Or in short, we can say it is right extreme point and the left extreme point. When the particle is at right extreme point, generally it is treated as positive. And when it is at the left extreme point, generally it is treated as negative. So x is equal to plus minus a and v is equal to 0. Because at the extreme point, when the displacement is maximum, velocity is 0. So if you use these boundary conditions, or if you use these two conditions and substitute this in this equation, what you get? As v is equal to 0, this v square by 2 is equal to 0, no doubt, minus, instead of minus omega square, keep it as it is, instead of x, I will write a. So what you will get? Minus omega square a square divided by 2 plus c. If you transfer this side, this term on the left hand side, as it is negative, it becomes positive, so that you will get c is equal to plus omega square a square by 2. So this is the value of c. This is the value of c, constant c. So you can substitute this value in this equation, so that you will get v square by 2 is equal to minus omega square x square by 2 plus omega square a square by 2. This 2 will get cancelled, and finally you will get v square is equal to omega square 1 2. If you substitute this value here, so what you'll get? You can cancel this 2 on this side, 2 on this side, and c, the value of c is omega square a square by 2. This 2 also get cancelled, and finally you'll get v square is equal to, if you take out this omega square as common, then you will get a square minus x square, so that you will get v square is equal to omega square into a square minus x square, because omega square is constant. Then if you take square root on both sides, then we'll get v is equal to plus minus omega. V is equal to plus minus omega under root a square minus x square. So this is an equation for velocity of the particle which is performing simple harmonic motion. So this is an equation for velocity of the particle which is performing linear simple harmonic motion. Now, displacement of simple harmonic motion. How will you find out the displacement of simple harmonic motion? So, as you know, velocity v is equal to dx by dt. Velocity v is equal to dx by dt. Now, dx by dt. This is equal to plus minus omega into a square minus x square. The same thing. This is the equation. Instead of v, you can substitute this dx by dt, so that you will get plus minus omega under root a square minus x square. Then again, we'll separate the variable. So the variable that is x, that will take on the left hand side, so that this dx is divided by this term, under root a square minus x square. Okay, this t is not there, t should not be there. Okay, so this should be strike out. So it will be dx divided by under root a square minus x square is equal to omega, keep it as it is, and transfer this t on the right hand side, so that you will get omega into dt. So now here we are separate the variable of x and t. Okay, so again integrating on both sides. If you integrate this equation on both sides, then what you get? Integration of dx under root a square minus x square is equal to integration omega into t. Then, integration integration. What is the integration of 1 upon under root a square minus x square into dx? So you will find that the integration of this term is sine inverse of x upon a. Sine inverse of x upon a. And the integration of omega into dt. Omega is constant, so we can take out it outside the integration sign. Integration of dt is simply t. So what you will get? On the right hand side, you will get omega into t. On the left hand side, you will get sine inverse of x by a. Sine inverse of x by a. So here you can see sine inverse of x upon a. Sine inverse of x upon a. Here there should be bracket. Okay. Sine inverse of x by a is equal to omega into t plus phi, where phi is again a constant. Where phi is again a constant, and the value of phi, it depends upon the initial conditions. So it is also called as the phase of simple harmonic motion. It is also called as the phase of simple harmonic motions that we'll see later on. But time being, what we can say, sine inverse of x upon a is equal to omega t plus phi. This bracket, instead of here, it should be here. Okay. So hence x is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. We got x is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. So this is an equation. This is an equation for the displacement of a particle. And here there are two particular cases. Now, till now, what we have seen, we have obtained the equation of an acceleration, the equation of velocity, and the equation of displacement. So all these three equations are very important. As far as this topic is concerned, these equations are very useful, because you can see here, this is the differential equation. By using this equation, you got this equation. d2x by dt square is equal to minus omega square into x. This is an equation for acceleration. This is an equation for acceleration. This is also an equation for acceleration. Means either you can write it as d2x by dt square is equal to minus omega square into x, or a is equal to minus omega square into x. This is the first equation, and that is for acceleration. So now, this we had obtained equation for velocity. Velocity v is equal to plus minus omega into under root a square minus x square. And finally, we got an equation for displacement, x is equal to a into sine of omega t plus phi. So here, as far as this displacement is concerned, there are two particular cases. So that we'll see. The first case is, if the particle starts its simple harmonic motion from the mean position, means when a particle is performing linear simple harmonic motion, there are two possibilities. Either the particle can start its motion from the mean position, either or it can be start its motion from any one of the extreme points. Means it may start from the right extreme point, or it may start from the left extreme point. This is one thing. Or it can start its motion from its mean position. So we'll consider both the cases. Means when a particle starts its motion from mean position, and when a particle starts its motion from extreme position. So first case is, if the particle starts its motion from mean position, So here, when it starts from the mean position, then x is equal to 0, because at the mean position the displacement is 0 and the initial time is also 0, so t is equal to 0. Hence our basic equation it becomes, this is our basic equation, ax is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. So if you substitute here x is equal to 0, then this term is equal to 0. On left hand side you will get 0 a sine omega into t, so t is also 0, so omega t is also 0, so what you'll get, a sine of phi is equal to 0, a sine of phi is equal to 0. You can see here 0 a sine omega into 0 plus phi means a sine phi is equal to 0, means sine of phi is equal to 0, means sine of phi is equal to 0. So as sine of phi is equal to 0, this implies that the sine function has 0 value for two angles. And what are that? The first one is 0 and the another one is pi. Means sine of 0 is 0 and also sine of pi is also 0. Means here we got two values for phi, that is what, 0 and pi, means either phi is equal to 0 or pi. So x is equal to, therefore x is equal to plus minus a sine omega t, because our basic equation is x is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. So if you substitute phi is equal to 0, then what you will get, x is equal to a sine omega t, you will get a sine omega into t. Here we have introduced this plus and minus sign. So what is the use of this plus, positive and minus? So positive sign is considered when the particle starts its motion towards the positive extreme point. Means if it starts towards positive direction of x-axis, by that time you will consider this positive sign, means x is equal to plus a sine omega t. And negative sign is considered when it starts towards negative direction, so means towards the negative direction of x-axis, because generally we will consider the sign convention as the vectors which are directed towards the positive direction of x-axis are treated as positive, and the vectors which are directed towards the negative direction of x-axis are treated as negative. So by using this sign convention, you will get negative sign means if it starts towards the negative direction. So this is about when the particle starts from mean position. So in that case, you will get the displacement x is equal to plus minus a sine omega t. So you must remember this equation, because while solving the problems, you must remember this equation is useful. Then we'll see the second case. If the particle starts simple harmonic motion from the extreme position, if it starts from extreme position, then x is equal to plus minus a and t is equal to 0. Means if it starts from extreme position, we know that when the particle is at extreme position, so the displacement of a particle from the mean position is given by plus minus a, which we call it as the amplitude, that we will see later on. Okay, so x is equal to plus minus a, this minus sign is written here, actually it should be like that, plus and below that minus. So plus minus a at t equal to 0. Hence the above equation becomes the basic equation for displacement, which is given by x is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. So if you substitute this value here, so instead of x I will write plus minus a sine omega t is equal to 0, so substitute t equal to 0 plus phi, then what you will get, this AA will get cancelled on both sides. So plus minus 1 is equal to sine of phi. So this implies that this phi, as the sine of phi is equal to plus minus 1, this implies that phi must have two values. And what are that? Either it should be pi by 2 or it should be 3 pi by 2. Either it should be pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. And hence, if we substitute pi, first of all, we substitute pi by 2, phi is equal to pi by 2, then what you will get? X is equal to the basic equation, x is equal to a sine omega t plus, instead of phi, I will write pi by 2. Okay? Or x is equal to a sine omega t plus 3 pi by 2. If we substitute phi is equal to 3 pi by 2 in this equation, then we will get this equation. Then x is equal to plus minus a cos of omega t, because what is the reason? Since sine of theta plus pi by 2, suppose theta is the given angle and pi by 2 is another angle. So if you find out sine of theta plus pi by 2, then this comes out to be cos of theta. So you can apply the same trigonometric function here. Here we have sine of omega t plus pi by 2. Means instead of theta, we have here omega t. So the simplified form of this equation is like that. This is equal to x is equal to a plus minus a cos of omega t. Cos of omega t means this sine of omega t plus pi by 2, it can be written as cos of omega t. Okay, this is equation. Okay, similarly here also you will get the same equation, a sine omega t plus 3 pi by 2, this is also equal to a cos of omega t. So we got this equation, means when a particle starts its motion from the extreme position, we get x is equal to a cos omega t. And if it starts from mean position, we get the equation x is equal to a sin omega t. So this is very important. While solving the problem, the condition is given in the problem that the particular particle starts its motion from the mean position. Means you have to use the first equation x is equal to a sin omega t. And if the condition is given like that, if the particle starts from extreme position, then you should use this equation of displacement x is equal to a cos of omega t. Here also we have introduced the plus and minus sign. So what is the meaning of this positive and negative directions? So negative positive sign is used if it starts towards the positive extreme point. Means if the particle starts its motion from the positive extreme point, then we'll use this plus sign. And if it starts its motion from the negative extreme point, then we'll use this negative sign. So this is about the various equation. This is about the various equations of the parameters such as acceleration, velocity, and displacement. So now, in tomorrow's lecture, we'll see an equation for maximum displacement, minimum displacement, an equation for maximum velocity, minimum velocity, and an equation for maximum acceleration and minimum acceleration. So here we are complete this subarticle, that is the equation of acceleration, displacement, and velocity for a particle which is performing linear simple harmonic motion.